Hit that subscribe button and bell icon so you never miss an update from Neela Bakore Tutorials. In this part, we'll talk about two more examples of the phylum Platyhelminth. We have already talked about Taenia solium, that is tapeworm. Now the example that we are talking of is Planaria. Planaria is a free living platyhelminth and they are found in fresh water. General characteristics are same as of the phylum Platyhelminth. But because it is free living, it has developed sense organs like eyes. It is also known as Dugesia. So Dugesia or Planaria, as they are free living, we would see sense organs like eyes. They have triangular head. So the head is somewhat triangular, and if we draw, this is the dorsal side which we are showing, or dorsal view, we would find that there are two rudimentary eyes, not very well developed, but yes, because it is a free living one, it requires these sense organs, and this is the triangular head. Then the body is flat and leaf like. On the dorsal side, nothing else is visible, but if we talk about the ventral view, then the ventral view, we would find the openings. So again, we would see this triangular head, but because this is the ventral side, the eyes will not be visible, and again the body. Now here there is mouth. So mouth is on ventral side. This is mouth. And the interesting thing is there is a tubular pharynx which is protrusible. So a tube like pharynx comes out of this mouth. So if we have to show this, this is protrusible pharynx. That means the tubular pharynx comes out of the mouth. This is the interesting structure, and this is visible only from the ventral side, not from the dorsal side. They are also hermaphrodite. That means both the sex organs are present in the same organism. The development is direct. That means here there is no larval stage which is seen. And in case of other platyhelminths, like in tapeworm, and one more which we'll be talking about in few minutes, that is fasciola, there are larval stages. That means in them the development is indirect, but here it is direct. So a young planarian comes out, no larval stages seen. They are hermaphrodite, but fertilization is internal and cross fertilization. Cross fertilization favors genetic recombination. Planaria is also very important for one more specific reason, that they have very high power of regeneration. That means if the body gets cut into pieces, then every piece is capable of giving rise to a new planaria. So this is again a very interesting thing about planarians, and it is a free living one. The next one is Fasciola hepatica. Commonly they are called flukes, and this is known as sheep liver fluke. The body is flat and leaf-like. Flukes can be bisexual or hermaphrodite. So bisexual as well as hermaphrodites. In them, the development is indirect, and especially in case of Fasciola hepatica, there are many, many larval stages are seen. So development is indirect with many larval stages. It is endoparasite. Endoparasite means it must be living or completing some stages of its life cycle in hosts. And it is digenetic. That means the hosts in which the life cycles are completed are two. So these two hosts, one is sheep or goat, and that is why the name sheep liver fluke. And the second one is a snail, and its name is limnia. So it completes its life cycle in these two hosts. Sheep or goat is the primary host and the snail is the secondary host. Primary host is the one in which it completes the sexual reproduction, and that host is considered as the primary host. So here it is an endoparasite. Life cycle is completed in two hosts. And hepatica word normally is associated with liver, and that is why we also call it the liver fluke. They feed on blood, lymph, and the blood cells. And how would the life cycle be completed? This is through sheep and snail, the life cycle gets completed. A part of the life cycle is done in sheep, where sexual reproduction of fasciola would take place, and the other stages like the spore formation and all would be completed in the snail's body. So this is again an endoparasite. Because it is an endoparasite, the sense organs are not present, and because it is an endoparasite, it is anaerobic. That means it can survive without oxygen in our liver or in the cells where this fasciola is found. Oxygen is not there to breathe, and because it is depending on the blood and everything from where it takes its nourishment, for oxygen, breakdown, there is actually no breakdown required, because from blood they absorb digested food, and then the breakdown which takes place in the cell is in absence of oxygen. So we say they are anaerobic. So this is endoparasite. Now one more example of this particular phylum is Taenia saginata, and this is commonly known as beef worm. It is actually similar to tapeworm, that is Taenia solium, but Taenia solium completes its life cycle in human and pig, and that is why it is also known as the pork worm. This completes its life cycle in human and cows, and how would it reach our body is if we consume those measly beef in which the cysts of this particular tapeworm would remain, and that when comes into our body would develop into this beef worm. So these are some important examples of platyhelminth. Now in the next part we'll take up the next phylum, that is Aschehelminthes.